Hi everyone, my name is Mitni Chavan and I'm working in middleware technologies like products at BRMS and different products like JBoss. I'm working on it. So I'm working with the Red Hat BRMS product last 4 years. So today I'm going to present a topic of Cogito. So I'll explain you what is Cogito, background of Cogito, and the features about the Cogito. So before going to understand about Cogito, we have to understand like first the Red Hat's business automation journey. This is the agenda of this. As you can see here, you can see the diagram of Red Hat business automation journey. And here you can see started from the earlier versions. JBoss rule started from 2007 and 2009 is going the enterprise version of BRMS. These are for the rule. And you can see the 2014 for JBoss BPM suit 6. So this is the journey of our Red Hat business automation journey. From BRMS to the latest one is RSpam. And now it's a Cogito. It is just a developer tools for business automation microservices. So this is only for the cloud, and we are going to deploy our processes and rules in Cogito. Okay, so you can, I think you can see the journey of business automations. So it's like from 2007 to 2020. So the latest version is 7.8.1 also there. So this is the latest version of RSpam where we can write our processes and RSDM also, Red Hat Decision Manager, where we can write our rules. So first, I'll explain you what is the Cogito. So before I'm explaining, I'll just show you one video created by our team, Cogito team. So I'll start this video and you will get the clear picture about Cogito overview.
Reduced IT costs, improved scalability, and greater flexibility. While technologies like Kubernetes and Quarkus make it easy for developers to build scalable applications for the cloud, developers still struggle when it comes to delivering business logic in cloud environments. That's because traditional platforms for hosting business logic, such as business process management and business rules systems, are often large monoliths that are not optimized for cloud and microservice environments. Long startup times and large memory and compute consumption lead to poor performance and even affect developers' productivity. What developers need is a way to work with business automation projects with cloud-native capability, greater speed, and low resource consumption. Say hello to Cogito. Built from the ground up, Cogito is a development and execution platform that makes it easier to build cloud-native applications that automate business processes and decisions. Using Cogito, business applications are built from models using standard representations like BPMN and DMN. Cogito provides modeling tools that are integrated with popular development platforms like VS Code, allowing developers to visually create business models and easily incorporate them into their microservices. Applications can then be deployed as containerized microservices that are managed by Kubernetes. Each application is packaged into a container with a Cogito domain-specific service optimized for its business logic, enabling much greater scalability and resilience. And with Cogito, a REST API is auto-generated for each application directly from its model, so developers can focus on implementing business logic and not the inner workings of BPMS. Because Cogito provides an open-source Quarkus extension, developers don't have to spend hours learning new technologies. Business applications built using Cogito are native Java apps that leverage all the benefits offered by Quarkus, including hot reload for business assets, low memory requirements, and fast startup times. Cogito makes delivering intelligent cloud-native business applications easier than ever. By taking advantage of the latest technologies like Quarkus, you get fast boot times and instant scaling on platforms like Kubernetes. And Cogito adapts to your business domain, not the other way around, so developers can stay focused on what the business is about instead of the technology behind it. Visit the Cogito website to learn more, try it for yourself, and connect with the Cogito community today.
Okay. Thanks for watching this video. I hope you have cleared. You got the idea.
Setting up our environment.
You got the ideas about virtual machine. What is Cogito and basic idea of our Cogito. So I'll also explain about the Cogito. What is Cogito and why we're going to use Cogito. So Cogito is currently available for development preview. Like development preview release contains features and API that might not be fully tested, but might change in the final GA version. So basically we are going to encourage to our users, community users for development preview software, they are using community. So, okay. Cogito is a cloud native based business automation technology for building cloud ready business applications. Actually, the name of Cogito derived from Latin. So Cogito basically is designed specifically to excel in a hybrid cloud environment and to be adaptable to your domain and tooling needs. The core objective of Cogito is to help you to set up business processes and decision into your own domain specific cloud native set of services. So when you are going to use Cogito, so you are building a cloud native application, set up independent domain specific services, like collaborating to achieve some business values. The process and decision that you use to describe the target behavior are executed as a part of services that you are going to create. So basically Cogito includes some components that are based on well-known business automation key project, specifically Drools, JBPM, and OptiPlanner. It's going to offer a dependable and open source solution for business rule, business processes. And you can see here, Cogito also aligns with the popular lightweight runtime Quarkus and Spring Boot. Basically, it's supported if some customers are using Spring Boot or some customers are using Quarkus. So it depends on the environment. So they can use on either Quarkus or Spring Boot. And Cogito is basically designed to run and scaling on a cloud infrastructure. So you can use Cogito with the latest cloud-based technologies such as Quarkus, Native, and Apache Kafka. Like what we are going to achieve here, we are going to achieve to fast boot times and instead scaling on container application platforms such as OpenShift. Basically, Cogito is compatible with the following technologies like OpenShift. The first one is OpenShift. OpenShift is based on Kubernetes. So it's the target platform for building and managing containerized application. So we can also see in our OpenShift 4 version, so there is an operator also available. So you can start working on that. Like you can install the Cogito operator and you can create your application and you can deploy it. And Quarkus, so the second one is Quarkus technology. So it's the new native Java stack for Kubernetes that you can use when you build application with Cogito services. The third one is Spring Boot. Spring Boot is also supported with Cogito if you are going to use Spring framework with Cogito. And the fourth one is GraalVM. GraalVM with the Quarkus, enable you use a native compilation with Cogito. The result, if you want to see, is a faster time response and minimal footprint. For example, a native Cogito service starts in about 0.003 millisecond. And about if we compare, like, so it's 100 times faster than a non-native startup. So fast startup is almost necessity basically in a cloud ecosystem. And that's why we need a small, some serverless application. And we have some monitoring tool also for their Prometheus and Grafana also there. And some, we have the middleware technology also, like integration part of Kafka, InfiniSpan, and KeyClock. This is all about your Cogito. So we will talk about first Cogito for Quarkus. So we already like discussed about the Quarkus benefits. It's like provide the fast dev environment, and it's already has a set of libraries and standards and framework that are available through extension. So we will discuss about extension also, like in demo, like how we will, we know, like we already available all the extension, RaySDG, SmallRay, KeyClock, Kafka. So Cogito also, it's a proper extension for our intelligent Quarkus application, and it's already pre-compiled business assets like BPMN file and rules. So it's going to like automatically generate a native executable with its own REST endpoint. Suppose if you create a, like a BPMN and your rules, and it will create automatically an own REST endpoint that allows to interact with its processes, tasks, and rules. So suppose if you run a Cogito application, so it will create one endpoint for that. So with the help of endpoint, you can easily interact with your processes, tasks, and rules. So this is a good way for developer also. Developer don't need to worry about the implementation of that logic. We already discussed about the runtime. You can see the faster runtimes if you are using in a native mode, going to compile it business rule execution. It's 100 times faster. Okay, and the startup time also super up. So I'll show you, like, to once I start the our Cogito application in JVM or native, like JVM mode. So you will see the timers also, like it's a very fast time, and it's like, no, we are not going to use like processing any additional like on the, our app. So we can see like in our example, so check out like the faster boot time. So as I explained you, like we are also going to use Cogito on our OpenShift. So it's a CRC code editing container. So I just created this video on YouTube. So I won't like show you, it's very long. So you can also refer data it's available in YouTube. So how to install our Cogito on like on code editing container. It's a OpenShift 4 based on, so you can see the all the steps like to install Cogito operator over the Red Hat code editing container. So it's very useful also. You can see here the way. I'll show you only that part, like to install the, so you go to there, installed operator, just you have to click on that. There are the steps, like it's already available index and apps. We have to create one Cogito app here. Okay, so this is the URL of our GitHub project. You can directly give it, the version is, it's an older version, but like I think the latest version, I think 0.15.0 or 14.0. You can change it from here. Once you like create the, your app and your build and deploy is completely. Once you've done your installation, then you can hit the API of your application. This is a simple way like to install Cogito operator over the code editing container. And now we are talking about the time of startup time in native mode, like it's 0.007 second, and take startup using GraalVM also. These are the output of from native and GraalVM. So for demo purpose, I'll explain you how to create the project, Maven project. How are we going to create a Cogito application? So this is a Maven based, so we are just using that Maven command. Once you hit it, and you will see other structure. I'll show you the structure of this. This is the structure will be created. You hit this Maven command in your terminal. Okay, so it will import like all the Cogito extension. We are going to use the extension wise Cogito. So it will come install all the needed dependencies, and it will configure up your application with business head automation. So basically in Cogito, basically we have to like use some processes and some Pojo classes. So I'm just going to use some basic person class here, model class. So just we have the attributes of name, age, or adult. So we'll use in a REST services the all the parameters once we deploy. And this is rule parts. We are going to create the one rules. This is a sample application. Basically, we are going to deploy our rules and processes within Cogito application. So it's a simple thing like person is greater than 18, it will modify the person. And it will set the adult true. Modify for the BRMS engine. It will notify to the BRMS engine. And this is a simple process. So we are going to like integrate our process with the business rule task here. So it will hit first here. Then it will go according to the our conditions. This is the process here. This is a user task and gateways and end node, start node. So once you like have all the information, this is the project where we have to use all the information. So I'll show you resources. So where you can see the, this is the rules which we have seen. This is the rule part and the process part we already have here, and the Pojo classes. Person Pojo classes. So there are many ways to like to run application developer mode, JVM mode, and in your different native mode. These are the way we can start it and see. I'll start my server. Okay. Well, I start the dev mode. I'm going to hit the command, the script and clean compile Quarkus dev. It will download some needed dependencies. It may take some time if you are going to start first time. It will take some time because if you're going to start first time, it will download all the dependencies. On the second time, it won't take much time. You can see it started. It took some time because it's the first time we are going to install it. And I'm going to use the this is the HTTP command to test our application. So we should get the output like this. Okay, so I'll hit test API. You can see the output. And ID and output here. So for the same also we can try with a JVM mode. So this is the command. I'll show you with the JVM mode also. So once you try it, it will compile and it will create one jar file inside target folder. So you can easily run it. It's already created one jar file. And see here, we have to use the jar file runner. And see, it started. Same thing we can try here. You can see the output. This is the way we have the fastest response time. And if you run on OpenShift also, then it's a very fast time. So there is approach also like you can. I didn't like cover this approach because it's a thing. It will take some time because we have different many features with Cogito, like the online feature also there with Cogito. It's a BPM and editor. I'll show you one editor also. So you can create your one second. You can create your processes and like rules and BMN file from here. This is the good editor here, and we have the Chrome extension also. You can use it. And we have recently launched at GitHub with the GitHub, so you can make changes within your GitHub, and you can edit there. You can make the changes and modify. So this is the fastest timeline. You don't need to install your RSpam, and there you have to create business like processes in Business Central. You can here like create new workflow, new models, and you can try it. Like some workflows, you can try it from here to create it. These are the it's powered by Cogito. You can see here, so you can create your process and your start node, task, and node, and you can save it and file action also. Like in copy and download SVG files. So this is also a good feature. We have many features, but difficult to cover every feature. So there is a website also available of Cogito. So you can go with the this. Website and we'll get many information. You can go with the started guides also, community. You can join community also there. So you need to know new features and some bugs also. So these are the thing like you can go through it, deploy Cogito services, OpenShift, some examples also there on OpenShift and without OpenShift. Like Maven Architect, serverless Quarkus. So you can go through it and you will know, get to know many more features about Cogito. I have covered like all the information, like basic information about Cogito. Guys, if you have any questions, let me know. And I hope like you liked my talk. Thanks for joining my presentation about Cogito.
Thanks, Amy, for his great presentation about the Cogito, the cloud native business automation. So And we are going to do the live Q&A right now. So if anybody have any questions related to talks, just type in the chat panel so I can feed them into the speaker. So Amy, I have a question. I cannot get confused. What is Cogito exactly? What Cogito can do and what we can benefit from it?
Am I audible, Van?
Yeah.
Hello.
Hello. Yeah.
Okay. Am I audible?
I'll
give you your answer of your query. Okay. So first of all, what is Cogito? Cogito is a next generation business automation toolkit. Okay. It's basically originates from well-known like open source project Drools and JBPM. Basically, we are using BRMS product. So it's good feature for rules and business processes. So it's like it's work on a cloud native applications. First of all, this is the Cogito. The definition of Cogito here. So Cogito can do like, if you are not using Cogito, so you have to install your product and you have to work on like embedded mode and you have to install on JBoss. So you have to depend on JBoss. So there is no dependencies of your JBoss and your BPM product. So you can directly use your functionality in Cogito application. So this is a good benefit and the faster response time also. And you can do the ad hoc changes also, no need to restart the server. So these are the benefits of like using Cogito. And we have different integration parts also. We have the like extension of Cogito, like we can use the REST-EG application and we can use the Keycloak. So these are best available on the key extension. So no need to like use the JVM part here. So we have already predefined JVM part also there. So these are the benefits of using Cogito here.
Okay. Thank you so much for the explanations.